Hello students, so today let's start with the second chapter from hunting gathering to growing food. They have started with a story, Tushar's train journey. Tushar was going from Delhi to Chennai for his cousin's wedding. They were traveling by train and he had managed to squeeze into the window seat, his nose glued to the glass pane. As he watched trees and houses fly past, his uncle tapped his shoulder and said, "Do you know that trains were first used about 150 years ago and that people began using buses a few decades later?" Tushar wondered, when people couldn't travel quickly from one place to another, did they spend their entire lives wherever they were born? Not quite. So Tushar one day was traveling from Delhi to Chennai with his cousin for his cousin's wedding. And he was traveling by train and he managed to get a window seat. Now he was continuously looking outside the window, his nose stuck to the window pane. As he was watching, his uncle tapped his shoulder, patted him and asked that, "Do you know that trains were used just 150 years before and bus were used after few decades of that?" So then Tushar wondered that if trains were not that in early times, how did people travel from one place to another? Did they spend their entire lives in a single place or at one place where they were born? That is not true. They did travel. So let's start with the earliest people. Why were they on the move? We know about people who lived in subcontinent as early as 2 million years ago. Today, we describe them as hunter-gatherers. The name comes from the way in which they got their food. Generally, they hunted wild animals, caught fish, birds, gathered fruits, roots, nuts, seeds, leaves, stalks, and eggs. We all know that this subcontinent developed about 2 million years ago. People started living here 2 million years ago. And those people who lived here 2 million years ago are described as hunter-gatherers. They are described as hunters or gatherers because they hunted animals and they gathered their food. They hunted wild animals, they gathered fish, birds, gathered fruits, roots, nuts, seeds, leaves, stalks and eggs. Stalks is dry grass. So they gathered all of these things. Hunter-gatherers moved from place to place. There are many reasons for this. Now they moved from one place to another. And the reasons behind this is, first reason is, if they had stayed up at one place for a long time, they would have eaten up all the available plant and animal resources. Therefore, they would have to go elsewhere in search of food. First reason is that if they stayed at a single place for a long time, there are chances that they might have eaten up all the animals or all the food that is available surrounding them. Because they didn't know how to grow, they just ate it. And therefore, even in search of food, they had to move from one place to another. Second reason is, animals move from one place to another either in search of small prey or in case of deer and wild cattle, in search of grass and leaves. That is why those who hunted them had to follow their movements. Now, hunters hunted animals. And these animals never stayed on one place. They moved from one place to another in search of either small prey or either in search of deer or any wild cattle that these animals can eat. And because humans survived on these animals, they had to track their movement and move along with them. Third reason is, plants and trees bear fruit in different seasons. So people may have moved from season to season in search of different kinds of plants. Different trees have different fruit bearing season. So if they want to eat certain fruits, they have to move from one place to another in search of different kinds of plants. Fourth reason is, people, plants and animals need water to survive. Water is found in lakes, streams and rivers. While many rivers and lakes are perennial, now perennial rivers are the rivers in which we can find water throughout the year. For example, Ganga, Brahmaputra, Yamuna. These are the rivers in which we can find water throughout the year. And then there are seasonal rivers in which we can find water only in rainy season. So people living on their banks would have had to go in search of water during the dry seasons, that is winter and summer. People, be it people, be it plants or be it animals, we all need water to survive. And water is generally found in lakes and perennial rivers and seasonal rivers. Now the people who lived on the banks of seasonal rivers have to move from one place to another in the dry seasons in search of water. So here we studied four reasons. Why did people move from one place to another? Why did hunter-gatherers move from one place to another? First, in search of food. Second, to hunt animals, they had to track their movement. Third, because of different plant-bearing season. And fourth, they need water to survive. So these are the four reasons for which people or hunter-gatherers move from one place to another. How do we know about these people? Archaeologists have found some of the things hunter-gatherers made and used. It is likely that people made and used tools of stone, wood and bone, of which stone tools have survived best. Some of these stone tools were used to cut meat and bone. Scrap bark, that is from trees, they cut the trees, and hides of animal skins, chopped fruits and roots. Some may have been attached to handles of bone or wood to make spears and arrows for hunting. Other tools were used to chop wood, which was used as firewood. Now wood was also used to make huts and tools. Now archaeologists, we know archaeologists are the people who study about the past. They have found some things that hunter-gatherers made and used. They made and used tools of stone, then wood, then bone. And out of all this, stone tools have survived the best because they do not get easily decayed. And out of these stone tools, they were used to cut meat and bone of the animals, scrap bark, cut the trees, and even hides of the animal skins, cut the scalp or animal skins. Then chopping fruits, roots, or for all these reasons, so stone tools were used. Some may have attached to handles of the bones. Some of these may be attached to the handles of the bones, or these stone tools were used to make spears or arrows for hunting. And the other tools were also used to chop wood, which was used as firewood. Wood was also used to make huts and tools. Okay, so in this image, you have been given stone tools. The left side is the tool. This is the tool that was used to collect edible roots, the roots which can be eaten. And this is the tool that was used for stitching clothes. Clothes that were made out of animal skin. We will continue with this part in the next class. Thank you.